In Oregon, the state house in Salem is boarded up this weekend, and the governor has called up National Guard troops. NewsHour Weekend's Mori Rothman spoke with Oregon Public Broadcasting reporter Sergio Olmos about far-right extremist groups there.
So you've been reporting on far-right extremist groups for a while now. Take us through how you've seen the actions of these groups escalate over the past couple of years.
You know, since the election of Donald Trump, these groups have gotten more kinetic. So they're out in the streets, and a lot of their rallies have ended in violence, either brawls or, isolated events outside of a hotel or something with paintballs, things like that. If you go to last year, August 22nd, there was a huge rally with right-wing groups standing outside of the Multnomah County Justice Center. It's like a jail for processing inmates. And they fought with left-wing activists for hours out there. And some of those people in the crowd would go on to, you know, storm the Oregon State House. You saw right-wing protesters, you know, draped in American flags and Donald Trump flags, bear macing Oregon state troopers. And, you know, many of the people who went inside that state house faced no consequences. And, you know, you draw a direct line from then to 2 weeks later, when you can see on video some of those same people standing outside Nancy Pelosi's office.
You've written about how you've seen some of these groups rise specifically in the Pacific Northwest and in Oregon. Tell me a little about that.
Well, you know, Oregon is 87% white, and it started built as a kind of white utopia. There were black exclusionary laws built into the Constitution. You know, the language in the Constitution, some of it, you know, said black people couldn't own land. That language wasn't removed until 2002, and even then, 31% of people voted against removing that language. So there's a racist history to Oregon, but there's racist histories to every state. There's reasons why people would join these far-right extremist groups that apply kind of everywhere in the United States. You know, some of them being that people are looking for identity, meaning, and purpose, and if you're living online and you have nobody, no community, no tribe, no group that will, you know, kind of vouch for you, hang out with you, sacrifice for you. These groups will invite you to come hang out with them. So I think there's structural reasons that, you know, push people towards extremism. And that's something that we can all look at.
What kind of preparations are being made in Oregon for potential violence? And does it look like people are being deterred by the greater police presence?
The Oregon State Police has requested the Oregon National Guard to be at their disposal this weekend. So the Oregon National Guard is in Oregon. They're in Salem at the State House, and together they will, you know, protect the State House against planned right-wing protests. As far as, you know, whether there's going to be crowds are going to be deterred from coming to protest, you know, the disruption of the social media platforms like Parler and things like that, they've really made it hard to gauge larger trends. So, you know, a lot of these far right groups have moved to Telegram, where it's smaller chat rooms, where they're split up and they're fractured. And it's really difficult to gauge what is a common agreed upon idea.
Yeah. And looking forward, what's the discussion around what these groups are thinking after this week?
A lot of these people are no longer on social media platforms. They're not on Facebook. They're not on Twitter. And so you're not going to be seeing this kind of stuff anymore. And you might be lulled into thinking that it's gone, that the problem has been fixed. But, you know, when you cover these groups, you realize something very quickly. This is not just an idea. You know, it's a lifestyle. These people have changed the way they live. This is their friends group. They buy gear. They, you know, watch YouTube videos. They spend a lot of time investing in this. And it's inconceivable to think that they're just going to walk away after this weekend.
Sergio Olmos from Oregon Public Broadcasting, thanks so much.
Thank you, Mori.